Well, hello there and welcome to Krasno Ask 2019, the home of the 29th Winter Universiade. We're at the Sotka Cluster in the heart of Siberia, where it's supposed to be cold, but you can see the sun is out. There's a slight breeze, but the weather is just beautiful. And the racing conditions, nothing short of perfect. It's time for the parallel giant slalom finals. The ladies will always go first, followed by the men's. The weather, well, it says partly cloudy, but I can assure you the sun is beautiful warming up this venue here. There's a slight breeze, but nothing really to affect the races. The starts, altitude 460. A drop of 130 takes us to the finish line at 330 meters above the city. There's 20 gates for the athletes to wrestle with. The ladies' parallel giant slalom has reached the final stages. And racing for bronze, really. It's called the small final, but we know that there's big pride for both. Natalia Sobolova. Fastest qualifier on the red course. Maria Volova for Russia on the blue as well. Disappointment could still well turn to joy. The first run of two. Remember, the quickest from the first run manages to start with an advantage of the same deficit for the second, and this one is super close. Russia versus Russia for bronze. Pride at stake. Sobolova cruising so much easier than the previous run. Volova looks as if she's going to have to settle for second. The first run is over. Sobolova is back to winning ways after that second place in the USA World Championships, although not today, just for bronze. Volova still has a chance at 0.40 back. Great bounce back ability from Sobolova. Extremely disappointing for her not to be going for top spot. Volova, 0.4 of a second back to Sobolova before the second run. The crowd can't wait. Our Russia going to see a gold. Milena Bakova is their only option now. Nobody thought that Bakova would be the only one to qualify for the big final from Russia. Run one. Milena Bakova, two times world junior champion. A 10th at the Olympic Games in this discipline in Korea last year. Is up against Hurim Yong from the Republic of Korea. Two times European Cup winner, but did not predict this one. She's already knocked out Natalia Sobolova, who was second in the World Championships this year. All to play for here. The gold medal will not be won and lost on this run, but every turn matters, as it's Russia against Korea. Bakova in the blue. Looks like she started slightly better from Hurim Yong, but Hurim Yong is such a competitor, and you can never count her out. We're almost halfway through, and there's still nothing between the two. Every turn means so much. It's a two-legged big final, and it's gonna go to the wire no matter what. Harim Yong by 0.12 is behind. Russia do take it online. It was so, so close. Russia have the advantage. And that means everything. Sport is about all of the small details coming together at the right time, and every tenth of a second means the world here. The ladies parallel giant slalom, small final, run two for the Brots. On the blue course, Natalia Sobolova, who was well fancied for gold, but it was not her day in that respect, is up against Maria Volova. Sobolova has 0.4 of a second head start from the first run against her Russian opponent, racing for pride and racing for bronze. Russia, who have sent their best team to this event, have made their fans proud. But who will it be? Sobolova on the blue course is racing fearlessly now and fastly. But Maria Volova is not too far away, that's for sure. Natalia Sobolova, as we reach the second half of the course, is almost three quarters of a gate in front. Two or three gates left for Sobolova. She will take it comfortably, and it's a great comeback after losing in the semi-finals. Natalia Sobolova takes the bronze, second at the Senior World Championship in this event at senior level, takes the bronze here at the Winter Universiade in Krasnoyarsk 2019. Proud moments for her, and also Maria Volova from St. Petersburg State University. Fourth place confirmation from the ladies' small final. Natalia Sobolova takes the bronze. The ladies' parallel giant slalom, big final, run two. This is it. The last day's worth of competition has come down to this. And Harim Yong from the Republic of Korea has been phenomenal, knocking out the favorite, Natalia Sobolova, to reach this point. She now finds herself 0.1 of a second down against Milena Bykova, who'll be racing on the red course. Harim Yong on the blue. And we are underway. A good start is really necessary on the blue course for Harim Yong if she wants to overturn this one. The Republic of Korea can be so proud of their racer so far. And she's got off to a very good start. She's overtaken Milena Bykova. The racers still on the top third of the track, but they're aware of each other. They know what the standing is so far. Harim Yong is about to do something incredible. If she can hold her nerve and cross the line, have Korea taken gold? Yes, they have. Milena Bykova, a 0.14 of a second of an advantage, has to settle for silver, and what a day. Harim Yong from fourth in the qualifications. The Korean National Sport University can be very proud of their racer. Raced on the World Cup since 2011. A best of an eighth in the parallel giant slalom. But today she takes gold. And Russia, who had all the authority going into this, have to settle for silver and bronze. Next race. Two of the favorites. The men parallel giant slalom has reached small final run one time. And this is an encounter fit to be a final. On the blue course, Dmitry Zarasimbaev took a 10th in Secret Garden last week. Loganov is the prince of Krasnoyarsk. And in his eyes, he would want to be racing for gold today after winning the Double World Championship last month. He's not quite racing his best, but he will have such a test. Racing on the red course, Dmitry Loganov against Dmitry Sarsenbaev. It looks as if Sarsenbaev is just off to a slightly better start. They approach midway, and it looks as if Loganov has taken his foot off the gas again, and he's gone. The confidence from Dmitry Loganov has just disappeared. It's a mental game racing. He's lost concentration. Sarsenbaev has kept composure. Loganov cannot link his turns. Has it all to do just for a medal now. Loganov with the DNF again. Two times in a row on the first run. Well, it's time for the snowboard men's parallel giant slalom. Big final, run one. And who would have thought it? Two Polish racers. Mikhail Nowaczek will race on the blue side. Oskar Kwiatkowski will be racing on the red. Kwiatkowski has already beaten Dmitry Loganov. Nowaczek beat Sarsenbaev. Poland have already delivered a great performance in these races. But who will win the gold? Mikhail Nowaczek in blue, in red, Oskar Kwiatkowski. It's a very close start. Poland already proud, but both of these racers, who will know each other so, so well, will want to take gold for themselves. It would be a great souvenir for both performances. There's mistakes from Kwiatkowski. He's lost so much speed going over the toe edge. And early on, it looks as if Mikhail Nowaczek has got the lead. Still, a lot of work to do, but half a second is the difference. Mikhail Nowaczek has come from nowhere. Seventh in qualification. People took notice when he knocked out Olympic silver medalist Sang-ho Lee from 0.4 of a second down to win by 0.02. And now he's got one hand on a gold medal from seven in the qualification. Racing takes a different dynamic, a different mentality. Poland are proud though. Unbelievable, and so they should be. The men's parallel giant slalom, small final for bronze. Again, it's an all-Russian affair. Number one in your picture, Dmitry Loganov, has to make up a daunting 1.19 second against Dmitry Sarsenbaev, who will be racing on the red course. Loganov on the blue. Russia, a guaranteed bronze. Sarsenbaev goes to university in Siberia. Loganov, he's a local of Krasnoyarsk, and he's the double world champion. But he will not be the winner of this Universiade, but he has it all to do. Look at the difference already. Loganov has to race his best here against Sarsenbaev, who was third in qualification, and it looks as if he's going to take the bronze medal so far. Sarsenbaev, the two-time junior world champion, 2016 and 2017, is getting caught by Loganov. Just when you think you've seen it all, but Loganov has got too tight to the gate, and there will be another DNF for Dmitry Loganov. Dmitry Sarsenbaev, congratulations. The bronze medalist from Krasnoyarsk 2019, the 29th Winter Universiade. It's disappointment for Loganov after a second in the World Cup last week in Secret Garden. His form and consistency is up and down, but what a day for Sarsenbaev, taking the bronze. Sarsenbaev is our bronze medalist. The men's parallel giant slalom. Big final, run two. Gold medal time. Everyone thought this would be an all-Russian affair. But Poland have well and truly upset the apple cart here. Oskar Kwiatkowski needs to find half a second here on the blue course against Mikhail Novacek, who's performed so well, beating the bronze medalist Sarsenbaev and upsetting Sang Ho Lee on his way to this point. Oskar Kwiatkowski will be racing the blue course. Mikhail Novacek will be racing on the red side. Kwiatkowski finds himself half a second down. And when we thought it would be Russia, Russia, it's Poland, Poland. And it's a very wide start on the blue course. Kwiatkowski is slightly struggling here, making a little bit of a comeback as we reach the second quarter of the course, though. 20 turns that are identical, and it could be a phenomenal performance here for Novacek on the red side. But it looks like Kwiatkowski is coming closer. Is he going to steal it? It looks as if there's been an upset. Gold goes to Oskar Kwiatkowski from half a second down. He's upset Mikhail Novacek. And it's by the narrowest of margins. A hundredth of a second. Poland take gold. Poland take silver. They can be so proud. Hugs all round. A hundredth of a second sums up our day here. The gold medalist from Krasnoyarsk 2019, Oskar Kwiatkowski. Nobody saw that coming. Even until halfway, one mistake proving to be costly again. Novacek took a first place on his last outing in Davos on the Europa Cup. Kwiatkowski took bronze. Now it's the other way around. Catching the gate, Novacek. And once you make one mistake, it's a long way back. Incredible shots of just the most memorable day. Oskar Kwiatkowski is the gold medalist and the winner of the big final, but Poland take gold and silver as well. Mikhail Novacek will be very happy with his day's result, although there will be some mixed emotions, that's for sure. What a day's racing. Polish flag flying high. Russia take the bronze in the men's. Where in the women's, Erim Young from the Republic of Korea has surprised a few as well. Pictures and memories that will just last a lifetime. Well, it's time for the flower ceremony here. Krasnoyarsk 2019, the 29th Winter Universiade. Third place representing Russia. Maybe not the medal she would have wanted after a second at the World Championship this year, but great performances for Natalia Sobolyova. She can be proud of her third place and bronze medal. another Russian on the podium, showing their dominance. And the future is very bright. Milena Bykova, a former world junior champion, takes the silver. And in emphatic fashion, Harim Yong has really performed well to upset Russia today. She's the gold medalist, a day that the Republic of Korea won't forget in a hurry. We welcome back Dmitry Sarsenbaev from Russia. And then the two Polish finalists, something that no one really expected. Poland were incredible. Third place, Dmitry Sarsenbaev, a 14th place in this event in Korea at the Olympic Games, two-time world junior champion in 2016 and 2017. Has to settle for the bronze here, though. But great racing all day. Very proud moments for Poland. Mikhail Nowaczek, from seventh place in qualification, national champion in 2018, takes the silver. And Oskar Kwiatkowski is the gold medalist from the 29th Winter Universiad. There's the podium. Poland take the top two places. They go down in history, moments that they and their nation will remember, and celebrations will surely continue into the evening. 11 different sports at 13 different arenas over 12 days. Krasnoyarsk 2019 is entertaining, enthralling. You do not want to miss a moment. It's been a pleasure to broadcast these exciting moments to you from the heart of Siberia.